Hello and welcome back to Faith Talk. This is our last segment, and on this segment we're speaking with Christopher and Sarah Pope, a young married couple here on the campus of Texas A&M University Commerce, and we'll be speaking about love, marriage, and God. But before we jump into that conversation, let's take a look at a few more scenes from Passion of the Christ. All right, and we're back on Faith Talk. This is Chris and Sarah Pope. Thank you guys for joining me.
It's an honor to be here.
Thank you. We're here to find out what it's like to be young, married, and serving God. So first of all, how long have you two been married?
Nearly 2 years.
Okay, and where did you meet?
We met a long time ago in Campbell, Texas, a small town. My wife had just moved to the school, and the moment I saw her, I had this thought that I should marry her. It was a God thought, actually. And we went to high school together. We've been together for 7 years now. Okay. And so that's how we met.
Of course, we know marriage is a sacred thing in our society. So do you all feel, with there being such things as common law marriages and boyfriends and girlfriends that have babies but live together and that are not married, do you still feel as though marriage is important in our society and that it's needed?
I think it's definitely needed, but I think that our society is starting to, you know, re-question the values of marriage, that they're not making it to be important as it should be. You know, you have people living together in premarital relationships where they think that marriage is just a piece of paper. So I think that marriage is starting to lose value in our society, but of course it's always going to be important in God's eyes, and we'll always try to uphold His standard.
And so what about divorce? Do you still think it's needed? Because some people say when you take your vows that it's till death do us part, and then others will say, well, divorce is there for a reason. So what would you say, Sarah?
Well, you know, the Bible says that there are reasons for divorce. You know, the Bible says that you could divorce your wife or husband if there was physical abuse or adultery, like cheating on your spouse. But my philosophy is really that God can do anything. No marriage is beyond repair. Mm-hmm. That if both people really want to fix it, no matter what's happened in your marriage, you can always overcome it with God. You can always find restoration and healing in God. And so I think that in those circumstances, yes, I would agree with the Bible, of course, that, yeah, get a divorce if you don't think that you can go through, you know, the healing process successfully. But I don't think that divorce should be happening as much as it has been.
Okay. As we know, in our society, there are a lot of things going on, and all of which we are taught to believe that everything that happens for a reason, and that it's God's will. So what do you think is the spiritual purpose of your marriage?
Well, God told us to get married, so that by itself was just being obedient to God. I think that when a married couple, you know, comes together, God, all the gifts and talents He's invested in each of you, they combine to use you as a powerful tool together as a couple, mm-hmm. in a way that He couldn't have done so before. And I know that Ecclesiastes says that time and chance happens to us all, so I wouldn't say I so much believe in soulmates and all that everything happens for a reason, but I do believe that marriage has a lot more importance than what we're saying it does.
Okay. You said that God told you to get married.
Yes.
What did He say? Was it just get married, or was it a special sign or something?
Well, God doesn't always speak in a direct, out loud, Christopher, get married. Okay. He spoke to us by pressing it on our hearts.
Okay. And what was that? Was it an instant connection between you two that you knew marriage was inevitable, or did it take a little time of pursuit between you and her?
Well, of course, you know, when we got married, we were, or not when we got married, but when we met, we were 14. So, of course, we didn't get married right away. Right. We had a relationship that developed over time, in which God was always the most important thing. And we actually, right after high school, I guess a year after we had been in high, after we graduated from high school, Chris, you know, we had, he had brought up the subject of marriage, and I was kind of like, well, we're young. We were struggling, you know, with worldliness at the time, and we were kind of in this idea of, I don't want to get married because people are going to think this or that. Mm-hmm. And but I knew when I met Chris, I knew we were going to get married one day. And so it was just a matter of being obedient. And so I prayed about it. We both prayed about it. And one day, God just made it as clear as day. I don't know how to describe when you hear from God, but there's mm-hmm. just this connect in your soul, okay. you know, it, get married. And it was like, yes, Lord.
Okay.
And a month later, we were married.
I'm All so right. glad we did.
If you're just joining us here on Faith Talk, we're speaking with Christopher and Sarah Pope about what it's like to be a young married couple here on campus. So before we continue with our conversation, take a look at what some students had to say about holy matrimony.
The temptation's always going to be there, but it's just like one of those, do you have the character to actually hold yourself back from that? And that's one thing that's really cool about being in high school and being a Christian, because you have friends that are also Christians that are also going to like support you and everything.
You see every single commercial, for like, you know, a piece of chocolate, it's someone's having sex in there. So it's just, there's a lot of temptation.
Sex is so big because like, it's so easy to do it, you know, and smoking and drinking, it's all readily, it's all available for us in college. So it's really hard for us to like
sit. All right, we're back here on Faith Talk speaking with Christopher and Sarah Pope about what it's like to be a young married couple on campus. So what do you two believe about using contraceptives and being married?
I'm really glad you brought this up because, you know, God's love shines through everything. And when I was 15, I was diagnosed with ovarian cysts, okay. which is required, very painful, extremely painful. And the treatment is contraceptive, you know, birth okay. control.
Right.
And, you know, at 15, of course, I wasn't having sex, but I had to be put on contraceptives because this could even cause infertility. And so I was on birth control, you know, the pill, until about a year ago.
Okay.
So even after we were married, we used it, but God really spoke to me, and he actually told me, if you'll stop taking it, I will heal you. So while I don't have a political stance on whether, you know, the Plan B pill or, you know, birth control contraceptive is, you know, right or wrong, I believe that life is precious, and I believe what God spoke to me, and I'm obedient to that.
Okay.
I know it's a controversial subject, and I understand where my Catholic brothers and sisters come from with thinking that contraceptives are a sin, but obviously with my wife having the cyst, it was so painful that we really didn't have another option until God told her to stop taking it. Obviously, it doesn't destroy life, though it does prevent, but if God told you he wanted you to have children, you know, and then Sarah in the Old Testament's like, well, I'm going to take, you know, birth control, that would have been wrong.
Okay. I want to thank you two for joining us here on Faith Talk. You've been watching Faith Talk. We've been speaking with Christopher and Sarah Pope about what it's like to be a young married couple here on campus. Thank you for watching and see you next time.
We're not crazy. See, maybe they don't realize that sitting high